Okay, we're gonna call this meeting to order. We're gonna start with the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. This meeting has been posted at all the normal posting places.
Motion to approve the agenda as presented.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to approve the agenda. All in favor then say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Pose same sign. Motion's carried. We are now on to school board self-evaluation and we are using the WASB template from there. So. How do you want to go forward? We're gonna do the questions that they have.
This is the first time this board has done this. Okay.
Yeah, this was instituted last year as part of the 100s.
100s.
Right.
Change. There were two or three examples given, if I remember correctly.
Yep.
And I think we just settled on this one. I think this one had the most questions to answer.
Yeah.
Covering different things, if I remember.
Correct. Yeah, there was a few different school district templates.
We would have adopted this in October, November of last year? '22?
A little bit, yeah, November, sometime in early '23.
Yeah, or '22.
This is the first.
Schooling late '22.
This is the first for this board to do this.
So, I was wondering if one of the ways to think about this, because there were a lot of questions asked, is to start with ones where people did not have fully achieved. Does that make sense? Sure.
Yeah. The other thing is, just to point out, we talked about just doing one meeting and then this document was also talking about multiple meetings.
So there's an overall.
I started.
That's, okay.
And then I was like.
The same thing.
Oh, wait a second.
Yeah, it was global and then a micro meeting.
Right, yeah, yeah.
And also a minute point, you cannot watch the summaries on our school computers from the YouTube channel.
Oh, really?
On this computer?
Mm-hmm. It's blocked.
Oh, is it?
You know, Nicole.
So we can watch YouTube on the computer, I usually use it on YouTube.
I thought, oh.
I had to watch it on here.
Oh.
Okay, so are we gonna start part two? Are we just gonna focus on part two of this document? Since that's the single meeting, which is what we discussed last month?
I think we start at the top and let's.
Part one.
So one would be global and then, and then see how that particular meeting went. I didn't actually notice a whole lot of difference between.
No, same questions.
Well, I mean, between what I was thinking through them, I did put more of my global comments in the global area than I did in the specific area about meeting thoughts, but I can go by the question, because we'll get to them no matter which way we go. Do you have a preference?
Let's go.
So you wanna start with the individual or you wanna start with global?
Oh, I was just starting with meeting preparation at the top.
Oh, okay.
Work our way through it.
So part one, I suspect, unless other people have, unless you have comments, and in some places I did put comments, that it would be the best use of our time to think of places where we didn't think we fully achieved. Because on many of these items, I had as marked as fully achieved. Is that?
Same.
The same with you.
Which always makes it feel.
The first one, seven, was the one, first one I had that we haven't fully achieved.
Correct.
I had a mostly achieved for three, but it's because there's a question I have about how we bring up things that I've never known where to put. So maybe I could bring that up here.
Yeah.
So this is great. I was wondering where or how we can have conversations about upcoming topics. Because we have at the end of the meeting, there's things you wanna talk about next time. But I'm wondering, do we have a list of things we want to get to someday? Or, because we've got, that aren't necessarily already being brought up by policy or things that we haven't talked about. And I never find a place to enter that. And part of what I'm wondering is, you know, if I'm the only person thinking about it, then it's possible we don't need to talk about it. But I don't know a good place for us to have that conversation because it has to be in an open meeting.
Yeah, I think how I would interpret that is when we get to the end of a regular meeting and next meeting and the meeting after, setting those dates. I think Ron typically says, is there any topics you want added?
Right.
So I think that would be the place where you say, okay, so like, for instance, we got January coming up. The end of January's meeting, when we're looking at February, if there's a topic that you want to have a general discussion on, I think at the end there, you say, at the February meeting, I would like this topic to be put on the agenda for the reason of X, Y, and Z.
Right.
Is that what you?
Well, sorry. My take on your question was, does it fit into necessarily a board meeting? And so there's been times that I've reached out to Ron and I, hey, I'd like to discuss this. What's the proper, or how do we get this on an agenda, or?
Well, and then part of me is what, like, there's the, I could put it on the agenda, but if people are like, you know what, nobody else is interested in talking about it, I could still push it if I wanted to convince you to talk about it, maybe it was a small thing that I thought, well, if I'm the only one thinking about it, it doesn't need to be on the agenda.
Or I've emailed Ron and said, can you share this with the board? Like, hey, I noticed this, or this has been on my mind, and then we can either put it on an agenda or something that way.
I think sometimes what we hear from our, in the community forum, if it's a topic that we think we need to address at another meeting, that gives us a little bit of persuasion to have Rob look into things and do a presentation on that.
But like you, if you sleep on it, like, so somebody brings up something in the community forum and then you sleep on it, and the next day you're like, so I didn't add it to the agenda, but where does it fit?
Well, I feel like it's a little bit also of the, so for the thinking about whether or not we should do the letters of resignation as a part of the packet. Right? That was up, we added it to the agenda, we brought it up. Part of what I was trying to figure out was where other people stood on it to know if we should be talking about it at all. Like, is this something that everybody's been thinking about it, or just me? Because that changes how then I prepare for the meeting, since I brought it up, right, that it's mine to prepare, but I didn't really have a motion. I was trying to get the temperature of the board to figure out if this is something that we're interested in doing. And I'm never really sure if an agenda item is a good temperature taking space. Does that make sense?
And to be honest with you, Rebecca, that right now that's the only avenue to do that, because we don't have, but when we work through our policy work about how to put an agenda item on there, one of the options truly is to have a dialogue, and the majority of the board would then have to agree for it to go on there.
Mm-hmm.
That's an option that the board decided not to. So,
just like you
bring it up at a meeting and say, hey, I'd like the board to consider this. Would a committee like to take this up?
Then I'm wondering, maybe, is there some strategic, it's not the strategic plan, but some board planning process that looks and says, and I brought this up in another area as well, over the year, these are some things we want to make sure that we get to. And then add things as they come in. And since I'm new to the board, I haven't experienced that with our board. I don't know if that's something that happened prior to April, although I was at the meeting, I didn't see anything like that. So.
In my 3 years, I didn't see it. And the year before that, I was coming to meetings, and I didn't see that. Although it was COVID, so it was different.
Right.
Back to what Ron just said, I think last year when we were setting policy, one of the norms we talked about establishing and respecting was, if somebody wants something on the agenda, to leave it on the agenda. Whether that elicits full dialogue or partial dialogue, part of it was to, you know, bring it on there.
In eliciting something, let's say I said something put on there, I could bring up, I have a policy I want to discuss, or could I say, I wanted this on there to see what, do a temperature taking on this. Because when it's on the agenda, we get it and we prepare for it. And so if you don't, is she bringing a policy here that she's going to discuss with us, or are we having just a general, what do we feel about this discussion?
But when you did the resignation letter agenda, you talked about why you wanted it on there, what you wanted to accomplish. I think that, at least for me, that was enough information to say, okay, I understand the assignment.
Okay.
Right?
Right.
like, I understand the assignment when it comes to that agenda item is think about these, what's the impact, and be prepared to give your opinion.
Okay.
You know, there was nothing more, there was nothing less. Now, future something might be more in depth. Maybe you have information, you want somebody to read, you know.
Right.
But I think, I mean, one board member getting off the board, but like, I think just putting it as an agenda and having a dialogue.
Just adding it to the end.
I mean, that dialogue we had on that wasn't all that long.
No, I didn't. But that was also my first experience. I was the first person to add something, and it was the first experience of my, on my 6 months of that happening. So I didn't know what that was.
And it was good to have the background, and like you said, I always appreciate having just a minute to digest it and be more prepared with an answer.
And we just need to be careful, like say, for instance, if you would, future meetings and agenda items, guys, let's talk about, do we want to do this? And that's one thing we can't do is really have an in-depth conversation about the topic because it wasn't a posted agenda item.
But we can talk about putting it on the agenda.
You can talk about putting it on the agenda.
And the reason to put it on the agenda. There's just not a discussion of it.
Correct.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And I've done that in the past where I've asked to put things on the agenda for the following meeting.
Okay.
And sometimes they get to the meeting and they vote not to talk about the subject.
Which is something we're trying not to do.
Not to do. Correct.
Mm-hmm. That was my understanding.
Yeah, I don't think we've done that now.
That hasn't happened since
it was discussed.
Yeah, that doesn't happen.
March of last time. Mm-hmm. Would have been the last time that was.
Okay. Well, I was really a process question.
Yep.
Perfect. So seven. I also had seven.
Yeah, and we had that situation at that October board meeting about something on the bill listing, and it always says bill listing. Gets questions in before 1 o'clock. So that was just anomaly.
It's happened twice so far, and again, I just asked the board to if there
be to be fair, it happened once. Once in a board meeting, once in a community forum.
Or once in a community
forum.
Okay.
So technically the community forum is the community forum.
Mm-hmm.
But I had it marked on that too because I was again, I kind of answered the multiple meetings and the,
mm-hmm.
and then I realized after the fact, I had that too as
right.
to, it just didn't give Ron enough time to prepare an answer. Now, we tabled it and we took it off there,
mm-hmm.
I believe is what we heard.
Yeah,
they
did.
And then came back, had the question been proposed even a few hours earlier. I think, you know, an answer could have been given and maybe we could have moved forward. Was it a big deal that we tabled it? No. But just from the standpoint of purely answering that question on this.
Yeah, I just said we've had
some
surprises.
Yeah.
And our conversation has been pretty consistent in what to do about that. I noted it but was not concerned about it.
My next one was 9. And I came back and answered this one differently, and I just said, I just felt like, and I'll put an asterisk by this, because it was more the community forum than the board, but it was the recess discussion.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like we weren't as prepared as we could have been, both from a standpoint of Dr. Russ and Kristen at the time. Now, I think it was also in that instance, in a community forum instance, you don't know what folks are going to ask you. So to be prepared there, it is what it is. But I think that one was on social media prior to that. And so that was my only, but I gave that a mostly a cheat. And that was the only thing
that's
I could think of.
Yeah. Mostly too, because of that.
Yep.
And that one, so it was in social media, but because it was also addressed in her letter, there was also some, we had some warning.
Correct. I do believe we could have done a better job, we being myself, Kristen, our team, making sure that we were all aligned, because what I thought was happening was not what was being thought of. So yeah, I would agree with Andrew on that one.
That was my only
thought
there, too.
Probably would have been better you guys being proactive than it ever getting to us as a board. You know what I'm saying? Because that's something we shouldn't have been dealing with as a board. So.
But we can't expect our administrative team to be monitoring social media sites and being proactive to reach out.
But it was in the resignation letter, the issue, wasn't it?
Yes.
It was, and I think, and we knew it was going to come to the community forum. They told us, you know, hey, I'm going to be bringing this up, and we knew it was going to become an issue. To Andrew's point, the board can't control what is said during that community forum, and we just needed to be better prepared in that situation, certainly.
Well, and to Andrew's point, I mean, we're here to represent the community, both school and around, so...
Lots of hats we wear.
Correct. I don't think it's a fair point to say it should never have come to the board when it's not up to us to handle it, but I think it's okay that we are made aware of it and have a discussion around it.
Particularly since it thought it wasn't functioning well, and it was unclear, at least to those community members, how it would be functioning.
Yeah, I thought it was, because again, the board ultimately needs to authorize, you know, a result could have been, we want you to find two more supervisors, for instance, if we do something. So I was okay with the topic, certainly. I just wasn't okay with how well we prepared and how we responded. When I say we are administrators, and myself.
Anything else on 9? Cool. 10, I think it's fully achieved. I wanted to say particular kudos to the policy committee where it comes to staff benefits and things like that. I think getting that stakeholder information has been proactive and really helpful. The part where I said I didn't know if it's fully achieved is I know that we continue to have, given the last survey, trust issues with the staff and their trust issues with the board. So I presume there's some stakeholder information we're not getting, but I also don't know what it is or how to better get it.
I would say mostly achieved. Obviously, just from the results of the last survey, there's clearly still work to do. One thing I thought that we could improve, and I know it's been the same forever, is if, and I don't have the answer for it right now, is if we better clarify community forum versus delegations to be heard.
Mm-hmm. And what happens in those spaces, which is, you mean like in a community education, like how we teach people?
Well, that delegations to be heard, you can talk about an agenda item, but you aren't going to get a response, where community forum, that's your opportunity for dialogue.
Mm-hmm. I had it fully achieved, and I was looking at it purely from the standpoint of whether it's an agenda item, or anything within the district, any adult has the opportunity to voice their opinion no matter what. Mm-hmm. So just looking at it from pure, I understand looking at it through the lens of the survey and the trust issues, I understand that. But I was looking at it purely from a standpoint of, we don't block people from speaking at community forums. In fact, we encourage it. Obviously, if it's personnel related, that we do block because that's confidential. We have to abide by that. But we have that. We also have the delegations to be heard. Anybody can email us at any time. Anybody can talk to Dr. Russ at any time, email Dr. Russ. So just from a standpoint of, are there avenues for people to talk to us? And I think the answer is 100%. Now, I think the lens of trust, that's different than, did we provide appropriate opportunities?
I agree with that.
So
I read appropriate opportunities during the meetings, I guess.
Yeah, and we have two opportunities.
Right.
One is unlimited. The other one is limited to eject, which was just the more recent change.
And we advertise the book to our to our parent community particularly.
Yeah, and I think the other thing too is I think we, while the agenda might not be fully set until, you know, 3, 4, 5 days before a board meeting dates are set 2 to 3 months in advance. And so I look at that as, it's an advertisement to folks to say, these are when we're meeting, you could come talk to us in person, and then there's always email and phone calls.
I had, so 11, I just had a, I think our committees are used effectively. It's, policy has a lot of work to do. For instance, student achievement has a lot of listening to do. So in the, it may just be that the board doesn't have a lot to do there, but the, I'm wondering if there is essentially something else I'm supposed to be doing as student achievement. I listen, I get the report, we ask some questions, but there's,
so when I view you as like the student achievement ambassador being on the committee, like, oh, that's Rebecca's specialty, that's Andrew's specialty. Not that we aren't all aware of what's going on, but I guess I would lean on you guys more for the nitty gritty.
Well, that's what I'm saying. And this may also be because we have a curriculum director, we don't have to do a lot of the nitty gritty because it gets presented to us. And
you have less.
Yes.
Because you all bring the information to us, there's not a lot of me to say, I would like to talk about this other curriculum bit.
And they're good about communicating.
Yeah.
Yeah. How I've approached it in the past, and I think I've been on it my whole time.
I think so.
There's a lot of reading to do, mm-hmm. right, of information. Okay. Instances in the past where I've, you know, I always heard, hey, we're using this, the book on continuous improvement. And I, it was one of those where, like, can I get a copy of the book? I'm going to read the book. I couldn't read the book. I admitted that to Maria. I tried.
Did you ever get a copy?
I have a copy.
I tried.
But
okay.
It's
very educational. It's hard for me. I fully admit
it's not a page turn.
I would read about 5 pages and I would be like, I'm going to sleep. But it was, my point is, I look for opportunities to, as a board member, your background being in education is different than my background. So I look for opportunities to like expand my knowledge of like, hey, keep talking about this. I should understand what it is you guys are doing. Now, I pivoted and asked Ron and the team to do a presentation on it because it was important to what our administrative team from a culture standpoint was trying to instill within the organization, both at this school and the other schools. I thought it was important to, for me as a committee member, better understand that in order to better support them when they're talking about what they're trying to do and how they're trying to do it, what tools they're utilizing to do that. So I approached it a couple different ways of like, what can I do? I've also approached it where if there's something in the agenda or something that we've talked about, I've emailed Maria on the side to say, hey, what else should I know about this topic? Mm-hmm. Is there a website or, you know, an article or something that I should be looking at? And, you know, she's provided that. And then I think the last thing I've just done has been to just get to know Maria more. Mm-hmm. And I probably meet with her quarterly just to go over things. And sometimes those meetings last 20 minutes. There's not a lot to talk about. Sometimes they last an hour because we're talking about, you know, she's taking me through deeper dives on things mm-hmm. so that I better understand. But I agree, it's a lot of taking in the information, asking questions periodically, but the majority of it, Maria and then the teams that she puts together to evaluate the various curriculums that we may or may not be adopting, they're doing.
Okay,
that's the heavy.
You don't bring all the information. Mm-hmm. So it's that it feels like more of a, my role feels more like to listen and be informed so that we know, because then you also present it to the board later as well.
Yeah. But I also think the policy committee, while it has been doing a lot of work some point, that amount of work is going to taper off.
Because you're doing this.
Because we're doing a 3-year systematic review on policies that haven't been touched in 20 years in some instances.
Yep.
25 years. And so it's much needed work and detailed work. But after next year, that should fall off cliff. Because then it's going to be, I think we set it up 5 years, right? Every 5.
I think we did 3 to 5.
Yeah. No more than 5.
Yeah, no more than 5. So like every 5 years, a board needs to kind of look at that. But that next look at isn't going to be as deep of a dive as this is, because we brought it from 20 years ago to the world we're living in today.
From 99 to 2023, 24.
So I hear what you're saying. And it's just the function of, that's the straw this board at this time drew.
This is what it is.
You know, even last year.
Sorry.
Yeah, no, it was, but it was much needed.
No,
it had to be done.
And next year it'll be a lot lighter when we get into the 7-800s. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's around 12 now?
Yeah, 12 I said NA.
I didn't think we were really doing this.
No.
I was wondering.
I put NA, not sure, but I said we don't really have, we don't have a current strategic plan. It ended.
Right.
We're obviously embarking on that journey today.
But
and to some degree, our agenda items or committees are addressing
goals,
district goals or strategic priorities. Like we had a meeting today, right? It was a listen and confer with staff on benefits and policy, policies and different things. Like, that's a priority that we established last school year, that, hey, we're going to continue this in the next school year. We report that. Like, in January, Ron will give an overview of what that meeting was and what we talked about.
Well, so the finance committee and student achievement and, yeah.
Yeah.
But I think it goes to your bigger point of, like, is there something to start a school year of a list of things?
Well, I think for a community also to, if you're attending each meeting or listening to each meeting, which are hard to hear, which has been reinforced after listening to this last meeting, the progress we know we are tracking is not always apparent to other people because we don't have at hand. We said we were going to work on this, we're going to talk about it in October, January, and April, and here is the thing that has been achieved from this thing that we set up. So I'm wondering if we could be more purposeful in making our structure visible.
What's the word we always use? Accountability, touch point, check balance.
And I think to Andrew's point, I think what the strategic plan can possibly recommend to the team to say, hey, we want quarterly updates, for instance, and then it specifically gets agenda instead of, like, for instance, what we do with student achievement right now. It's a big priority in the district. And at a board meeting, a formal board meeting, when I review it or Maria jumps in, it's a very, hey, we talked about this, boy, holy cow, take a look at our data, it's going up. Instead of, at student achievement, we spend 20 minutes talking about it. So that I put partially achieved because we kind of just do a brush over.
I said partially.
And maybe we need to get a little bit more in depth. And that's something that maybe the strategic planning committee can help with us.
Well, we do have an involved community who is looking, and so helping them to see what it is that is happening on a more structured basis, I think would also help with our visibility of the really positive things going on in the district.
Yeah, and part of that can come from Ron's information portion of the agenda. How do you
make that bullet point where
we can make
talk
it a little
about,
bit more, right?
Yeah.
Highlighting goals we're trying to achieve.
And once the strategic plan comes through, then perhaps making sure every 3 months we touch each the pillars in order, this is what we're doing, so that it's not overwhelming, but it is also consistent.
Right. Or you take a pillar every month and then
yeah,
you're
that,
okay.
Yeah, I guess that's essentially
what
I meant. Yeah. Like every 4 months you would hear about this pillar, so you're presuming we come up with, let's say, four. That they would, you'd hear about them 3 times in a full year.
13?
I said not achieve.
You said not achieved.
Not achieved.
Definitely room for improvement.
Yep.
So I had that question in a previous meeting, how we make that happen, and you said we tell you we'd like it to happen. So is there supposed to be more structure that we add to that?
No, because we're working with the building leadership teams and the climate and culture teams, and I think this is going to be something that'll come out of the strategic planning team as well. Because when we start talking about workforce engagement, recognition and things, but our building leadership teams are taking a look at that.
And I will tell you, I think you touched on this last time you asked this question, but it happened before COVID, didn't happen during COVID. We brought it back for a period of time. And then there started to be some chaos within the district.
Which we didn't make kids around.
Correct. And so it was kind of tabled because of some of the challenges of, you know, communication that we were having.
Polarization, that's what happened.
But we are all set for a student. We have a student showcase ready to go, and we've talked about it from an administrative team. We will have a student showcase the rest of the year moving forward.
And then I also wanted a student showcase if we should be doing some kind of, like, we've done informal shout outs for things that we know are happening with kids.
Yep.
If we should have a, we get a list of, here are our math weights that some of us have, and the spelling bee folks, that it shows up on the social media, but it would also be nice for, I don't know if that's something that should be recognized.
Those are all things that we're talking about, absolutely.
And like primary does Mustang of the Week.
Oh yeah, yep.
Anything that happens at intermediate, or does that kind of fall off?
They don't, that's something we can certainly talk to
them about. The primary started it for a particular goal.
Sure.
And I don't know if that was muted or named here. Something to, yeah, I haven't heard anything on that level. Okay, so we know we want to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Next thing, or anything else there?
Nope.
Next thing we...
We didn't have it until 16.
As do I.
I mean, you know, I point to the check question, like nobody had enough time, and I realized that was a one off there, but it was one of those we were evaluating and maybe not scattered kind of rebels.
So I can put in, and this is what I've got the other kind of question too, but that's something I think we're getting better at. We haven't formalized in how we do things, so I was thinking about the individual meeting with the overall meetings that we're very fast. So the example of talking through the ORs. Through that conversation, we eventually got to the three big considerations for the decision making: time, money, and the stress on
the
current group that was a donor person. But if Nikki hadn't been here to bring that up at the end, we weren't going to get to that point. That was not named. So that we got there, but a little bit accidentally. So trying to think about as we have these conversations, having some space to say, what is a factor we have not named? Because sometimes somebody thinks, oh, well, everybody thought that. But until it came up and it was, in fact, the factor that then swung and bookended the rest of the discussion. So it was important that it was there. And we might come up with it if you were not. But having that space of, what have we not named yet, I think would help us to make sure that we're getting the impact, because your question was impact of the decision. If we do this and we name that a third person, we're going to train somebody here to have this third person look at it, we already don't have enough people to begin with, who's really going to do that? That was a big impact of the decision moment. And so thinking of how we can be more conscious about making space for that question is something I think we've been doing it. But I also see sometimes where we could have missed it when we get excited about this point and we never get back to this other effect. Did you have any thoughts on that? Do you think I'm off?
What?
I think applying that to any discussion.
Yes.
You know, it's kind of the old, what's the unintended consequence of our decision here that we haven't actually talked about?
came by and saw the data in one way, and a third group came by and said, well, what about, we talked about these people, what about these people over here? And they were the only group to say that. And so something I mentioned to Joanne later is having the question of, we said this about the data, what about this negative space here? Here's what it showed over here, what's here. If that group hadn't brought it up, we might have skated right off by it. So making that a conscious, what else is in the data, or the, what is the unintended consequence?
Having you on board is going to allow that to happen. Just strengths and weaknesses of people, right? And
yep.
Teams.
Yep.
You know, you think about that. Nikki's very reserved in her thinking and thoughtful and listens really well, and then speaks. So like that combination, that I think that's really what the dynamic was in that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because if you, I listened to the meeting today, you didn't have a lot to say, and then you said what you needed to say, and it was that, that's a good point, you didn't think about it, right? And so you were kind of taking it all in, and that's kind of how you were.
And when you said it, I thought about that, but we had not talked about it. And so me thinking about it, and maybe everybody thinking about it, is guessing it's on everybody's minds, but we don't know that until we do this weird thing we do when we have to have these discussions in front of everyone.
Thank you for saying that, because that's kind of my goal. It's, I try to take it all in and then respond. Sometimes double advocate, sometimes...
So, and having been saying that here, I think is also good for all of us, because then when it comes up, what we're saying is that we all agree not to be annoyed at people. Right? Well, great, you brought up another point. Well, thank you. You brought up another point.
That particular conversation, and I had it in my comments here, was like, it was open,
mm-hmm.
It was respectful, everybody took turns to speak, and share their ideas, and everybody listened. Like that was the,
mm-hmm.
When you think about that conversation, you know, everybody did those things. Was it a longer conversation out of the whole meeting? Absolutely. But I think that's the essence of what the board should be doing.
And it came from policy saying, before we wade into this, we want to talk to the board about plots there, which is something else I'd mark as positive.
Yeah, it was one of those, I think, as policy committee, where there's two people.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes there are just things that everybody should have to say. And then sometimes there are things where we'll just make a recommendation. But at least that's how I approach
mm-hmm.
the policy.
Mm-hmm.
There are some items that come up where it's like, I don't want to worry.
We do the brainstorming and
I had one marked as mostly achieved, and now I don't know why I did that, so I'm just going to skip it because I've been staring at it and I can't remember what I had. The next one I had was 22.
I had one thing for 19 for the public comment. I'm wondering if we can ask people to introduce themselves and give some.
That's a great idea.
Especially when the camera's back there.
Yes.
And I need to make a point of saying when you speak to us and tell us who you are, whether you're a parent or a staff member, because when we look at the film afterwards, we don't know who's speaking.
Right. And when people come to multiple meetings, I'd love to know their names, especially if they've been speaking, then I feel like they know my name, but I don't know theirs. And for the public record, I also think it's really important to have identified.
We do actually keep people, the names of people signed in.
Mm-hmm.
That all goes back with Peggy, going back with her. But it'd be best if they address who they were and what they're, who they're representing. Or.
And is it a possibility, sorry, Dean, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Oh, go ahead.
Is it a possibility to have those audience members have a microphone, just just because it is somewhat difficult if they're not.
Oh, for them to hear.
Right there.
Yes.
If they're in a normal setting, this is split, right?
You can just take one of these and pass them around.
Yeah.
Nathan.
Or do we not want to do that?
I don't know, dude.
I mean, you can ask them to please come up and we can podium here.
I hope they're there too.
I mean, we can say, hey, we're gonna ask you to come to the front and speak to the board either in front of us or there's a microphone.
And Benny can always cut a mic, right?
Just so we know. Lose the mic.
Well, cut a mic is difficult because you've got some First Amendment things.
Oh, okay.
You've got some First Amendment things, I think we're past that.
But
we have to trust people.
For the purpose of hearing, I do think having a microphone, and like Arrowhead, you have to come up to the podium, but that's a much bigger board in a much bigger room. So if bringing somebody.
I think you just gave the microphone, say, we're gonna respectfully ask that you please introduce yourself, and can you speak into the microphone so we all can hear you?
And we know that we have people watching at home, and they can't hear.
Right.
I think that's helpful.
And the same thing with us, we need to be closer to the microphones.
Do we have, now have five microphones?
No, we don't have.
Can we get one? So, it seems like a not very expensive way to make sure everybody is heard.
Well, is there, can we lavalier?
Yeah, so if we think of lapel mics would be such a huge difference in being able to hear.
Because I think it would.
I know we have lapels, and I don't know if those are just tied, if you tie into here. We use them when we were in the gym. So I'll check it.
I think it'd be worth more. I mean, all these YouTube channels, all these guys have a wireless one. So there's got to be a technology.
The community has asked. I think that's the question I get asked the most.
Yeah.
Is can we get everybody?
And having to rewatch the meeting. Mm-hmm. I mean, I had my computer cranked all the way, and I'm like taking my ear thing and like shoving it to my head.
And I'm sharing with Dean over there, so you can kind of hear me. And it's not like I'm a quiet speaker, but.
And sure were, though.
I'm so quiet.
And then the other piece is, there shouldn't be comments going back and forth in an open meeting setting between a couple people on the board. Everybody should, anything they say, everybody should be able to.
Oh, you mean like the aside that's away from the microphone?
Yes, and lean over and make a comment. Technically, we're an open meeting. Everything should be.
Andrew's
there shouldn't be any secrets.
How fast I talk. That's
yeah. Yeah, I'm guilty of it.
We all are. Yeah.
So the lapel mic, you have to be very aware that you're wearing it. But other than that, I think that would help.
And don't run to the restroom.
That's right. Either that or we need a fifth mic. And probably a sixth, because you should have one as well. Mm-hmm. When you're
I'll talk to you.
Oh, let's see. Did you say 22 was the next one you had?
I did.
That's the next one.
And that, I would say, was more in the context of globally.
Yep.
Just, I think, since spring of 23, it's been a lot better. Our meetings have been a lot better than it was last year. And so that was my only reason for not giving it a full, because I've had some work to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we've done a lot of hard work as a board to have some norms, have some good dialogue. There's always room for improvement, but you know, I think a year from now, if everything continues, I think that's a meets expectations or fully achieved versus I said partially.
And that's the feedback I've heard from community members is that they appreciate how meetings are going. One person came up to me the other day and she said, someone told me that I could watch the meeting and it will not send my blood pressure, so I have to go to the doctor, which is why she had stopped watching it. And so she said, so I watched one and it was true. Oh, thank goodness.
I would agree with Andrew too. Mostly achieved getting much
better.
We continue to grow in that area based on the hard work and the listening, just like we talked about with the open records conversation.
We have four members who regularly are here, and if it was not, that is, I don't know what to say about that. So I put mostly a sheet for that. We have 20 series participates, but. how we talk to one another, and so being short and number on a regular basis means that the things that we establish as norms, and even our shorthand knowing how to run the meeting and how to work together, is affected by that change. That was my only comment there. Any post-meeting, I thought everything was good follow-up. Are we on post-meeting?
I am.
Good follow-up, consistent. You're very good with coming back with the data that people ask for and remembering to follow up. And it comes up in the next meeting. You seem to keep a thorough list.
Open-ended questions or any comments there?
No, I think we have covered everything. At least I did.
Did you have any other what went well? I said we're very pleased to be part of a prepared board.
And we are respectful to one another, let other people have their opinions and be able to walk away and not feel like you can disrespect you.
Yeah, I think, and again, said it before, but I think personally, when I look back last year versus this year, maybe once some of the angst that I had, frustration I had, is the back and forth on agenda items, voting to take them off, not take them off, having that out of the way, and I was guilty of the two, having that out of the way and everything being on an agenda, and whether it's talked about for 5 minutes or 20 minutes, I think that has been a really good kind of board norm that we've all lived up to. And I think it's helped to smooth things out, if you will.
But it also respects everyone's time, because if it was on there, someone's probably prepared something to talk about and then not to have that opportunity. Because you talk about it, and everybody could say, well, you're very interested in that, but everybody else is, at least that person would talk about you. I think that's respectful. I've also been very impressed with, for the most part, our collegial tone with one another. So good tone without being, I can't say this because somebody won't like it. This kind of deference to what you see in some boards. They don't look at one particular member, they don't talk to somebody because there is that person uses their tone to control the board. And that's something I'm glad we're not doing.
One of the things I just would like to mention, I think Andrew does it probably the most, and Rebecca, I think you jump in too, is making sure that all voices are heard.
You know, I would never say Nikki does it better than
I do. I think he does too. The board itself is making sure, like, Dean, Troy, you know, just what do you think? And really, over the last several months, making sure that everybody is, you know, engaged, mm-hmm. pulling them in to really get their opinion. I really like that. What you guys have been doing.
And I think we've been covering this, but one of the things I hope that we'll get to as well is when you have conversations like this, multiple people conversations, right? You get a row that goes off here and you wanted to talk about something this way, but the whole conversation went that way. So far, at least from what I've noticed, people haven't said, oh, well, we aren't talking about the thing I want to talk about anymore, so they don't. Because that restricts our decision-making ability. So asking people if they have anything and allowing them to come up with, we didn't talk about this part, I think has been useful, and it sounds sincere. I haven't heard I have to ask, maybe so I can check this box that I asked everybody, at least I received it as a sincere request. So we've kind of gone back and forth on these others. Do people have other notes about the individual meeting?
I was blending.
Yeah, I blended them as a blend.
9 minutes. Or less.
I only had one other general thing to keep an eye on as we go, particularly as we go into we're going through the strategic planning thing and the parts that will come to the committee, is that there's the identifying all the decision-making points, figuring those parts out. Then there's also being able to speak to the prioritization. Some of the things that we will disagree about is that somebody thinks that this portion is more important than this other, because all the decision-making points are not equal. And so making sure that we are figuring out how to talk about that. So this is what we do when we say, Dean, you and I didn't completely agree on taxation. Is that accurate?
Yes.
And so I want to be able to say that I appreciate your point and agree with your point. I don't hold it as high a priority as I held this other thing. So I want there to be a way to be able to let you know that it's not that I think you're wrong. In fact, I think you're accurate about how the community will feel about this. My reason for wanting this decision to go this way is because I held another decision point at a higher priority. So I want that to be clear. Because if I really think that you're inaccurate, I should also be able to say that.
Right.
But I wanted you to know that, said, that I didn't think you were wrong. I just didn't think it was the, from my perspective, the priority that I put the priority elsewhere. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Yeah. And that's part of wordsmanship. You have to be able to respect what's important. And you know, the old saying is that there's certain hills you're not going to die on. And there are, you don't always get your own way, but you need to be able to share with one another that this is an issue that I really take to heart. And that's part of being on board, to be able to do that. And for the most part, we've done really well. And I'll tell you, when we start bringing the kids back in here and showing what the children are doing, that just brings so much positivity to a meeting, because we're celebrating the really good things that are happening. And we did that for years, and it was great. We were, and then all of a sudden we lost track of it. We weren't celebrating things, we were griping about things.
Well, the world changed for a little bit, thank you.
Yeah, the world did change.
The world changed for a little bit, which is, and we've, I think, as a people, not just as a district, but as a people, in general, we've been trying to figure that out and slowly trying to get back to kind of that
normalcy.
It's a different normalcy, but
yeah.
It's a new,
It always is
a new normal, you're right. But
new
I think,
territory to navigate,
yeah.
And
but I think we're getting there. I think we have. It's been a much more positive time frame in our district. I think part of that is driven by us as leaders saying, trying to refocus things on positivity, because, you know, for a period of time, and I'll admit, you know, the nickname that I had from some prior board members was Mad Dad in the audience before I got started. Dean, you know, but it was to your point, I was passionate about something, right? I elevated something more important than other things, and started getting involved, and that's how things happen. But it was during a time of a lot of change in our with our world and our society as a people, and I think we're getting better at it, and we're getting back to some sort of new normal. And I think the constant discussion about positivity, I think, has helped change the direction since springtime.
I agree.
I really do think it. We as a group have been talking about we need to celebrate successes more, whether it's through gym. Doing all the social media stuff. Maybe only 16% of people like that, but it's out there and people are seeing it and they're celebrating it. And I think that's a good thing. And let's continue.
Great.
All right. Anything else?
This is a useful process. I'm glad we went through it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah, appreciate it. Thank you. Well, thank you for everybody's preparation.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
We have a motion and second. All in favor then say aye.
Aye.
Meeting is adjourned.